You've probably heard of diabetes, but did you know that babies can get it too? 1 in 260,000 infants suffer from diabetes globally, with India having one of the highest rates. Premature babies are most vulnerable. Diabetes is typically tested using blood tests to detect changes in glucose levels. You know from prior experience as a child that these tests can be painful and scary, so you can only imagine how infants feel undergoing these same tests. As Team 59 in the Vibe 2021 internship program at WPI, we strive to change the status quo by designing a painless, non-invasive system to test for diabetes.
We researched 4 non-invasive methods and selected the best one. Testing using ISF is expensive, difficult, and involves skin penetration. Newborn infants don't sweat much, so this method was inviable, and urine tests are outdated, only accurate for severe diabetes. That leaves saliva as the best option.
So, we introduced SalvoMeter, a new way to test for infant diabetes using saliva in premature babies. The design is based on a lab-in-chip technology research done in 2017. There are 5 of the many reasons why it's a great device. Number 1, it's painless. There are no needles involved. Number 2, it's non-invasive. Only saliva is collected for the testing. Number 3, it's quick. The time taken for the measurement process is a mere 4 minutes. Number 4, it's accurate. The saliva glucose levels are converted to blood glucose levels using a conversion factor obtained by extensive research. Number 5, it's affordable. The product is made with readily available materials and will cost less than $30 for the device itself and no more than $1.50 for one measurement, which is amazing for developing countries like India.
Our design consists of 3 main parts. Saliva is collected in the first part. In the second part, saliva is mixed with an enzyme and then a coloring agent. Finally, glucose concentration is electronically measured and displayed in the third part.
We have designed this pacifier for the collection of saliva. The pacifier has tubing through it, which enables the upward movement of saliva. It is fitted with a syringe at the upper end for manual suction so that the saliva can move up easily.
There are 2 steps to the second part, the pre-treatment and the mixing. The pre-treatment part is based on a chemical reaction using glucose oxidase to convert the glucose in saliva to gluconic acid and hydrogen peroxide.
Saliva is injected through inlet 1 and a mixture of glucose oxidase and HRP are injected through inlet 2. This produces hydrogen peroxide in proportion to the glucose concentration in the pre-treatment part. Next, a colorizing agent is injected into inlet 3, which turns the mixture blue in accordance with the concentration of the hydrogen peroxide. The microchannels in the pre-treatment and the mixing parts are designed to increase mixing efficiency by installing obstacles along the path to generate a turbulent flow.
The third and the last part of our design is a display of the blood glucose concentration on the LCD display. For that, let's look into its electronics.
Our LED is used as a light source which passes the light through our sample containing H2O2. The transmitted light is then detected by a photodiode which is connected to an Arduino Nano which is then further connected to an LCD display. The whole circuit is powered by a rechargeable lithium battery and a switch is used only to power the circuit when in use. To display the concentration of blood glucose on the LCD display, we have used Arduino IDE to write our program.
So that's SalvoMeter. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button below.